A very good afternoon to one and all. As we all know that we have gathered here for the peer evaluation. So let us start with the group number 16. Group number 16, please present. Group number 16, are you there? Last call to group number 16.
Next okay. Group.
Let us begin with group number 15. The team project topic is handwritten digit recognition and the team leader is Aniket Bedarkar. The presenters are Sakshi Nirke and Ashutosh Vasagade and the evaluator group number is 16. I request team number 15 to please present the presentation.
Hello, am I audible? Hello?
Yes.
Okay. Is my screen is visible?
Timer has been set, right?
Yes, ma'am, it's set and your screen is visible, Sakshi.
Yes, thank you.
Good afternoon, one and all. Hello, everyone. My name is Sakshi Nirke and I am from Group 15. So today, I am going to explain you OMT and UML designs of our project. Let's get started. So, our mini project is handwritten digit recognition. Group members are Aniket Bedarkar, Sakshi Nirke, Ashutosh Vasagade, and Ayush Pandey. And our guide is Ms. A.R. Deshpande, ma'am. Objective of the project is to convert handwritten digits, images or photos to a typed message, typed text. Then the whole system overview is that we humans can read images simply by looking in a few seconds. We can identify digits, but for the computer, they don't work in the same way. They need some data in an organized way that they can understand where the optical character recognition comes up. In it, handwritten digit can be converted into a digital text, which is very useful. While it also gives some error, but it is convenient and easier. Now further move on to the OMT diagrams. OMT has proposed three main types of models, which are class modeling, dynamic modeling, functional modeling, in which we are going to see class modeling in that class diagram. So, what is class diagram? What is class diagram actually? It's a type of static structural diagram that describes
just a moment. Sorry to interrupt, Sakshi. This is the class diagram that is of your group, right?
Yes, ma'am. Hello, ma'am. Hello. The class diagram is a type of static structural diagram that describes the structure of a system by showing the system's classes, their attributes, and operations or behaviors. We have our first class. We have our first class as input image, in which the attributes are all about the image description, that is image ID, image name, etc. And the operations are get image details and get image. Then our next class is recognize, which is subclass. And
sorry to interrupt, Sakshi, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
So just go to the first slide, 1 minute. So here you are expected to explain your second slide, hand digit recognition, right? So you go to the next slide. So this is instruction for all the presenting teams. You explain here your system and then you just talk about your class diagram. Okay?
Ma'am, I'm not getting.
So you have to talk about your system. Explain your system that you have drawn for. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
And the classes, and with respect to that system, what classes you have taken? That you tell me.
So with the, as I said, so with respect to the system.
With your system, you have to speak. Okay. So we'll start again. Just problem description and the class diagrams.
Okay. So our problem statement is converting handwritten digits at scanned images or photos to type text. So our system overview is humans can understand the photos or images simply by looking, and we can recognize the digit on the images as a text. But the computer don't work in the same way. They need something more organized data, means so where optical character recognition comes in. In that, as by according to system overview, we have taken classes as image input recognition, then pre-process segmentation. According to system overview, I'm telling, so pre-process segmentation, then feature classify, build NN, then validate, and then output. So these are our main classes. Sorry, these are our classes which give the system overview. Ma'am, can I go to the class diagram?
Yes. You have to all do it in the time limit given to you. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. So, our first class is input image, which gives a description about image description, image ID, image name, and the operations are get image details, get image. Then our next class is recognize, which is subclass, and it is dependent on the class in which is dependent on the class input image with one-to-one cardinality, and the attributes are digit, image size, image, and its operations, or we can say behaviors, are load image and process image. In this, process image will call pre-process, means recognize class will call pre-process, segmentation, and classify classes, as they are in connected with inheritance notation. In this, we will go to pre-process. Process image will further process the image by calling the operations. So after recognize, first pre-process class will call, then segmentation, and then classify. The recognized class and these three classes are connected with the inheritance line notation. Inheritance line notation. In pre-process, these three methods will call step by step. Firstly, we have an image, then it will get converted to grayscale by using converting grayscale method. Then the converted grayscale image will threshold will then it is it will convert it to sorry thresholding method, then for clearing the noise cancellation, for clearing the noise of the image, then the image will be converted to binary format by using convert to binary method. These all changes will be saved inherited by the recognized class. Then segmentation class will be called, in which the pre-processed image will be segmented, means every digit will get separated and will form box around it to identify. Again, the changes will be inherited by the recognized class. After this, classify class will be called and will proceed with the feature extraction method. Feature extraction method will extract the feature of the digit. Then further the data will trained and tested by calling build NN means build neural network class, build neural network class and classify class. Both are connected with a composition line notations and one-to-one cardinality. After training and testing data, validate class will find the nearest possible digit. By using operation, find nearest result. As validate is the part of classify represented by aggregation line notation, the classify will take the digit as it is a superclass of recognize. Recognize will inherit properties, that is the result, and will store in the digit attribute. Here recognize is also superclass or parent class of output class. So output class will inherit the digit and will provide the output by using get digit method. So our next diagram is use case diagram. Use case diagram. So what is use case diagram? In UML, use case diagram, use cases specify expected behavior, or we can say operations, but not the exact method of making it happen. Here we have user and system as two actors which are interacts with use cases. Then we have use cases connected with actors with communication link, and a system boundary is the entire system. Another thing is that the stereotype extend identifies as an extend relationship, and the include stereotype identifies the relationship as an include relationship. So firstly we have user who will upload the image, then the image will load by the system and we'll pre-process it by including its three cases. First, convert image to grayscale. Second, thresholding. Third, convert. Then convert to binary format. Then after this, the changes will be saved and the segmentation will segment the digit. Then it will go to the image classification. Use cases, case in which features will be extracted and the relation is extended, which is with recognition use case. Recognition use case includes train neural network and find nearest result. So when we get the nearest possible result, the output will be generated and the respected digit will be printed. So our next diagram is activity diagram. Activity diagram is basically a flow chart to represent a flow from one activity to another. Here we have six main activities. So from initial state, user will upload the image. Then the system will check that the image format is valid or invalid. If yes, then we will go to the system will go to the image format is valid or not invalid. If yes, then we will go system will go to the next activity. If no, then the system will go to the end of the process. The valid image will be pre-processed. Then the segmentation of characters will take place. Then feature extraction will extract the characters. Then recognize characters, and the last activity is to generate output as text, and the process will end. And our last diagram is sequence diagram. Sequence diagram is a type of interaction diagram. It describes in What order a group of objects objects works together? We have actor symbol, then lifeline symbol, the activation box, which represents time needed for an object to complete a task. Here also, the scenario is same like earlier diagrams.
User, I'm sorry to interrupt you, Sakshi, but the time is over. Please wrap up in 1 minute.
Okay. Same like earlier diagrams, user will upload the image, then the image will be loaded and into the recognized class, and the image will get stored in the recognized class. Then image will be processed. In pre-process, image will be converted to grayscale thresholding and convert to binary. When the pre-processing is done, segmentation will happen by line and word separate. We will separate the digits, then classify. It will go to the classify object to extract the feature of digit. Then the build NN object will train and test the data. Then validate will find the nearest solution. When we get the nearest solution, get digit will get the digit and will generate the output and will display the output to the user. With this, we are end with the diagrams. Further, I will hand over to Ashutosh Vasagade.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes.
You're audible, but the time is up.
Hello. Okay. Let's have a look at the UI.
This is the next team, Madhuri.
No, it's team number 15.
Okay, so the next presenting team, what?
No, ma'am. Graphical user interface design.
Okay. Okay, fine. Let it be, Madhuri. Just let him tell, because team number 16 has not turned up, no? So you can give the time. Not a problem.
Okay, can I continue?
Yeah, but do it fast. And who is the evaluator team for the group?
16.
Okay, so your images are not validated. Your diagrams are not being evaluated, right? Peer review has not happened of your diagrams, no?
Yes, ma'am.
So there are a lot of corrections. We'll go for it. The naming, so you did you go through your diagrams once?
Yes, ma'am.
So basically there are a lot of conventional mistakes. So we'll take that, but you complete the graphical user interface right now very fast so that we can proceed with the next group. Okay. So just a note down that Sakshi Rikre, the corrections, naming conventions for the class diagrams and the sequence diagrams. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
And the process flow. Okay, go ahead. Very fast, Ashutosh.
Yes, ma'am. So as you can see in the top right corner, there is about and contact us, and in left corner there is home button. So in main screen we add three buttons, that is upload image, submit, and save as document. When user click on upload image button, the image will upload it on next screen, that is size of the image. The size of image can vary. Then user will submit the image, it will be processed and it will get output at digit. And user can download this in the document. Next slide. This page will give information about us. Next slide. When you can click on contact us button or main screen, user will appear this page where user provide us feedback and it will be sent over Gmail. Next slide. Thank you.
What are the pages developed in?
Yes, ma'am.
Pages developed Prashamadhi Kale. Kisme kiya hai pages ko develop?
Yes, ma'am. Me.
Yeah, in which language have you developed these pages, or they are ready-made templates?
No, ma'am. HTML and CSS.
Okay, good. Okay. So the related to the diagrams, okay, the flow is okay, but the naming conventions, there is a lot of problem. So I will give a lot that corrections to be done. So we'll take it up offline. Okay.
Okay.
Same. Yeah. Good work. Keep it up.
Thank you, ma'am.
Most important, the you have, did you fill the Google Sheet that has been shared by this one?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
Okay. Fine.
Okay, so now let us call upon the next presenting team number 14. The topic of the team is courses and workshops website development. Team leader is Shivani Kulkarni. Presenter is Shivani Kulkarni. And the evaluator group is group number 15. Team number 14, please present.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Okay, so we are group number 14. Our topic is website development for courses and workshop. Our group is of Shivani Kulkarni, Sagina Kota, and Ruchika Ambat. And our group's guide is Didi Ausekar, ma'am. So the problem statement of our project is to design and develop a web-based application for taking courses and workshops online. The system deals with developing a website for courses and workshops. Motive of this project is to create a platform where users can enroll in various courses or attend workshops of their choice. User can select courses from their choices given and join and complete the courses by watching the videos, reading documents, and taking quizzes, which are part of that course. And for workshop, they can register for the workshop and attend it when it's on its scheduled time. OMT diagrams are drawn for this project are class modeling, dynamic modeling, and functional modeling. We'll first see class diagram. This is the class diagram for our project. The classes we have taken are user, and user depends on the login, so the dependency is given. Then user can select or register for workshop and courses, and association is used here. And for every course, there is a course tutor who can upload the course content or keep a watch on the user who is completing the course. So we have used a class course tutor, and every course is under a section. There are various sections and under each section, there are various courses in that. So the course is inherited from the section. And every course has course items. There would be videos or documents, etc. So their composition is given, strong aggregation. So if course is there, the course items will be there. This is our class diagram. And for object diagram, we have shown the instances of the class diagram of the classes. It's according to the class diagram. This is dynamic model state diagram. First, the user will log in to the website. So the state is logged in. If login failed, user can try again and log in. After login, user can view sections and select a section. After selecting a section, he can view the courses which are part of that section and select a course. And at the same time, user can view the workshop and select a workshop too. And after selecting workshop or a course, user can register for the course or the workshop, and it will redirect to the course tutor, and it will ask for permission to enroll in that course. And after course tutor gives the confirmation, user can access to the course content, and after he can log out from the website. This data flow diagram. Our system is website development for courses and workshop. There are three physical external entities: user, admin, and the course tutor. user can register for courses or workshop, and the system can provide courses and workshop. Course tutor can upload content, course content to the website, and after when user requests for permission, he can grant permission for the courses, and admin keeps watch on the whole system and gets report of the whole system. It's a data flow diagram level one. So user, these are three physical entities, user, admin and course tutor. User first logins to the website, and when login checks if the provided details are valid from the database, and if they are valid, user can select the course. Courses are stored in the course database, and user can select from workshops as well, and workshop database is present. After selection, he can register for course or workshop here, and after while registering, he asks for permission to course tutor, so user details will be passed to course tutor, and course tutor gives permission. After getting permission, user can access to the course content, and the course content database is present, so he can access the course content from here, where course tutor and admin can upload the course content to the course database. Now UML diagrams. This is class diagram, same as I explained before. Object diagram. Use case diagram. User has access to, user can log in to the website, view courses and workshop, register for course, register for workshop, and admin can view the profiles of all the users, create new course, remove course, modify course, upload course content, and view number of users for particular courses. And course tutor can log into the website, and after that it can modify the course, upload course content, view number of users from the, for that particular course, and grant permission when user requests for permission to join a course. So this is use case diagram. Now sequence diagram. First, user enters to the website and then choose a section. System gives message to choose a particular course, and he enters the course name or selects a course, particular course, and then register for the course or the workshop. And while registering, it sends request for permission to the course tutor, and when course tutor gives the permission, course gets allocated to the user, and user can access the course items. This is activity diagram. User logs in, view all courses and workshops, select a particular course, and if the permission is granted by the course tutor, the course gets allocated, and user can access the course. If permission is not granted by the course tutor, the course does not get allocated. And this is merged, both conditions are merged, and user can exit from the system. This collaboration diagram, this is same as before. Enters the system, select section from section, and after that is select some course or workshop, ask for permission. After granting permission, he can access the course content. Otherwise, if permission not granted, he can select some other course. This is self loop. Component diagram. It's all portal and all the components of the system database. This is deployment diagram. This is web server. You can choose course or workshops. These are user devices. Application server will be consist of information of the courses or course tutors. And database server will be data and records of all the courses. And this is graphical user interface. This is the home page of the courses and workshop website. Here are all the sections, course workshop articles, and here from here you can log into the website. These are all the courses. You can register for the courses. And this is the login page. You can log in. If forgot password, there is option. And if it doesn't have any account, you can register for the course. And this is for the responsive design. In mobile view, it will be shown like this. This is responsive view from mobile view. Courses will be displayed like this. And this is contact us page. User can contact to the developers. Thank you.
Can you take to the GUI design, Shivani?
Okay, ma'am.
Who is the evaluator group for your team?
16.
Okay, group number 16, are you there? Who is the evaluator for your group?
15. Group number
15 is there. Okay, group number 15, can I have someone from group number 15?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so Aniket, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So are there any corrections that you feel in the UML diagram?
Yes,
and the corrections that you have given, are they incorporated? So one minute, just a moment. Yeah, I'll just talk first. The thing is that just unmute yourself, rest of them. Okay, screen on and just unmute yourself, Shivani. Okay. So one thing that is to be noted in this presentation is that the evaluator team has to see whether the changes they have given, are they reflected? Because I think one sheet is shared to you by Tejasri. Tejasri, is the sheet shared to you, sheet to all the students?
Yes, ma'am.
Of the template marks and the today's presentation marks?
Sheets are there.
Okay, so the evaluator team again has to give the marks for presentation also and for the diagrams. So please be attentive while you are listening to your peer group. Also, the things that they have to identify is whether the corrections are incorporated in the PPT. And if not, Tejasri, add one more column over there, remark. Changes not incorporated or changes incorporated. So I will have a complete view what was previous, and most importantly, the teams that have uploaded, they have to upload the PPT as before and after. The same name, just at the end, right? Before PPT and after PPT. Means I can get a view. Is that clear? Okay, so you can continue and just show me the screen diagrams, the GUI. Shivani? Shivani, over to you.
Yes, ma'am. This is the GUI, ma'am.
Next. So is this a ready-made template, Shivani?
No, ma'am. We have wrote the code in HTML and CSS used.
Okay, fine. I'll get back to you. So, evaluator team, do you have any questions?
No, ma'am.
Are the corrections incorporated?
Some are there, but some are left, ma'am.
So, in the remarks section where you are giving the marks, you have to mention what are remaining. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
You have before and after PPT. So, that applies to all the groups. Okay, so Tejasri, just add the third column remarks over there. We can go for the last team now. Okay, before I move ahead, so let me tell you all, unmute yourself, everyone. Okay, so the thing is, this particular exercise of virtual presentation and communication is basically done with an aim that all will get to learn the things, okay? Learn management skills, like if at all there are 80 students in the class, at least in the what benefit Madhuri used to get every time, like every responsibility was being given to Madhuri. So on her request, and I also personally felt that it should be a group activity, and therefore we have divided the organization also, then the evaluation and the presentation in a way which can be effectively executed in this virtual environment. Now, one more thing what I felt is, and what was requested by the students, is that one rule we are going to make. Now, last time we had a presentation, and last time there were anchors in the groups. Okay. So the next presentation, means the this coming series and the final demonstration presentation, we will not have the repeated students giving the presentation. Like Sakshi was the one who presented the last synopsis presentation. Sakshi?
Yes, ma'am.
You presented the synopsis presentation, right? Last in the first round?
No, ma'am. Aniket presented.
No, just recall it, Sakshi. The synopsis presentation.
Yes, ma'am. First presentation was done by me.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So, you were not at all a part of it?
Yes, ma'am. I'm a part of it.
No, no. Means, didn't you last time share the screen while speaking? Is my question. Was it delivered by Aniket completely?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. So this is what I want. So if the first presentation, how many team members are there in your group?
Four members.
Okay, so Aniket has done the synopsis presentation. You have done the presentation for the UML diagrams. So
yes,
in
ma'am.
The third round, the remaining two will be speaking up.
Yes,
is
ma'am.
That clear? We will give everyone the chance, because I have got to know that everyone wants to speak, okay, and repeatedly the same faces are coming, and that is why we want to give equal platform to all, and equal everyone should skill should improve. So ones who have already spoken will not speak henceforth. Okay, the ones who have not spoken will be speaking up. So in that sheet also, we will be adding. So round one, presenters, round two and round three. So one more column. So presenter for round one. So I will circulate that. Not a problem. So is this clear to all the next groups now from tomorrow onwards? Madhuri and Tejasri, is this clear, the rule?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
ओके सो जिन्होंने पहली बार प्रेजेंटेशन किया है राउंड में, वो फिर से रिपीट नहीं होगा. हर एक टीम मेंबर्स को इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलनी चाहिए. जैसे भी वो बात कर सकते हैं, वो उनको उस सामने आना है और अपना प्रेजेंटेशन स्किल्स इसके द्वारा इम्प्रूव करना है. ओके सभी को जैसे अपॉर्चुनिटीज मिल रही है वर्कआउट करने की, एग्जीक्यूशन करने की, तो उसी तरीके से. और अभी तक सो फार सो गुड. दिस टाइम फर्स्ट राउंड वाज एग्जीक्यूटेड वेरी वेल बाय 1 to 5, एंड दिस टाइम आई एम आल्सो सीइंग वेरी गुड कंट्रीब्यूशन फ्रॉम 6 to 10 ग्रुप नंबर्स. ओके सो इज दिस पार्ट क्लियर? सो शैल वी गो अहेड नाउ? दिस इज द लास्ट टीम, राइट तेजस्वी?
यस मैम. टीम 13 इज रिमेनिंग.
Yeah, so team 13 for today, we will end with team 13. Tomorrow it will start on time. So Abhijit Mali, group number 8, he is taking the attendance, right? So
yes,
Abhijit, yeah, please note down the attendance of different towers, right? Because some students have left out. I want the attendance immediately uploaded to me. Okay. And you will give me the list of absent numbers also. Okay.
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we'll continue now. Go ahead.
Okay, now let us call upon group number 13. The topic is online book portal. The team leader is Krishna Gaikwad, presenter is Krishna Gaikwad, and the evaluator for this group is group number 14. Team number 13, please present. Hello, team number 13, are you there? Please acknowledge. Last call to team number 13.
Okay. I think they are not there. Can you also call out the remaining team members?
Just a minute.
So please don't answer on the chat box. Kindly speak up. Okay, so I think we are done with right now.
Ma'am, someone is responding over chat, ma'am. Ma'am, shall we wait or we are good to wind off? Hello.
Yes, Tadasri, did you speak up with them?
Ma'am, we are getting responses from the chat and I guess they are presenting, ma'am.
So basically, this is a learning experience. By the time he said, so everyone should know the checking, the settings, because this is the need of the hour, and that is only our objective. Like any time, the technical problems can crop up, and we should be ready to face them, and not only face them, but also fix them. And unless opportunity is given, we cannot see who is able to do and who is not able to do. And I see that some team members are also helping them through chat. So very good initiative. This is like what is expected and what is actually the objective of this entire exercise and the activity. So good, Sarthak is helping him on offline in the online environment to fix the things. That is very good teamwork, irrespective of the team that he doesn't belong to. Yeah, that option can be taken up by Mallikarjun and present from laptop. Sarthak is very right. So you can use this method to fix it for the moment.
Good afternoon, ma'am. I'm Mallikarjun Tuttak. I think,
yes,
ma'am,
good
our
afternoon.
Ma'am, presenter Krishna is not available, ma'am. He's not responding. So I will overtake, ma'am.
Hello. there is just a suggestion. Please, if you are using two devices, turn off the sound from one device through which you are presenting.
Oh, that is the laptop.
Yes, ma'am. Can I share my screen?
Yes, yes, you can go ahead. So this is basically the learning experience that the students will get. And this is what we are expecting from this entire activity. So good to go. Mallikarjun, you can start with the presentation.
Is my screen visible now?
Yes, it is visible.
Okay, good afternoon to everyone. Basically,
make it in F5 mode. Make it in F5 mode. So whenever you are presenting actually a presentation, you have to ensure that the slideshow is started. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. So basically, our project is on online book portal, and the project is made by Krishna Gaikwad, Vaibhav Pukhade, Arun Malevade, and myself, Mallikarjun Thuppar. The objective is to design and develop a web page online book portal using Python. The system overview is online book portal is a web application where the customer can purchase and sell second-hand books online. Through a web browser, the customers can search for a book by its title or author. Later can add to the shopping cart or finally purchase the credit card transaction. The user can log in using his account details or new customers can set up an account very quickly. They should give the details of their name, contact number, shipping address. The user can also give feedback to a book by rating on score or of 5. The books are divided into many categories based on subject like software, database, English, architecture, etc. OMT diagrams. There are three types in OMT: class modeling, dynamic modeling, and function modeling. Class modeling. We taken class as user, customer, seller. User is also a customer, and he is also seller. So we use dependency in your customer and seller. Seller. And there is another class admin. So admin is taken watch on the user which are dealing with the product, books, or any transaction or something. There is another class books. So a seller can search books, the user is also a seller or also a purchaser. So he can both do the sale or purchase. So customer is contact to the seller or his contact to the seller and give them which product he wants. Dynamic modeling. Here the user login, then hello, am I audible? Hello.
Yes, you are audible. You go ahead. You are audible absolutely.
So user login to the website, and when he logged in, he can verify through the password. So if failed, so user can re-login. Then if he want to sell, then he go to the books detail and another book details and other details, and after that he go for the verification, and if verification is done correctly, then the data will go to the database. And if we want to buy a book, then buyer will go to the search box where he can find various books, and he contact to the seller by phone or mail, or he can make payment and afterwards the book is delivered or not. Next we can go to the functional modeling. Here, user, if user login successfully, then he creates add. Add means here it is not here add is cart basically. He success if he login successful and search through the books and he can add to the, his shopping cart, then stores into database. And there are other categories. Viewers can also watch and website using website and user login records. Here class diagram as explained before. Use case diagram. In use case diagram, user first user will log in, then login. After login, user can view the books. If we want to sell a book, he go to the book details and sell book, include seller details. If we want to buy a book, he views a book and if user wants to buy a book, he go to the he first view the book and then go to the details of the and then he search for the details of the book, price, etc., and the condition of the book, and then he will contact to the seller, and after contact seller, and he will make payment. And activity diagram. In activity diagram, user login, then if user want to buy, then he will search a book. If after he search the book, he will check the product is available or not. If yes, he view details. He will contact seller, and if the deal is successful, he goes to the payment. If not, he will search for others. And if we want to sell through the then he will give his details. He will verification, and then if the verification is successfully done, then books add to the user. And if no, then he will recheck the details. Here the interaction component diagram, deployment diagram, collaboration diagram, and here the GUI. GUI is made through the Spark Adobe, where our website name is Book Bhandar, as shown here. Thank you.
Okay, so good. I just want to know that was your presentation reviewed, Mallikarjun? Who is the evaluator team? Can I have someone from the evaluator team?
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, is the presentation reviewed, Shivani?
No, ma'am. They uploaded just 1 hour ago.
Okay, fine. So I want that, Mallikarjun. It was a good attempt to meet the deadline. However, I would like to give some suggestions. First is the template. There is a template that is given as a uniform standard template, which is used by all the students. Okay, so you have to follow that template. Secondly, the visibility of the diagrams. I could not read the class names or anything. There was a lack of visibility in pasting the diagram. So please correct that. Only after that I will be able to read what is present on the diagrams. So the evaluator team, kindly in the remarks section while you are uploading the marks, mention this point and evaluate their and fill their peer presentation template and give us, so that tomorrow or day after tomorrow, Mallikarjun, you have to again represent with the correction changes. Is that okay?
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, so good that at least the participating teams have done well, and the entire exercise is like to learn up and to upskill on different fronts, that is the hard skills, the technical skills, the virtual skills of presentation. So good experience. So you will be getting a good form also, feedback form, and also the sheet is being shared to you. So please fill in it today itself. All the evaluators for today's presentation will fill it immediately after 1 hour, within 1 hour. And there is a remark column wherein you have to enter whether you have give the remarks or the changes have been incorporated or not. Okay, so Madhuri, you can conclude the session. This particular session will be made live, and it is a request to all the students. So go and visit to the channel and review and see how you have presented, how was your narration, what was the way of your delivery. Also today I will be sharing the first presentation, that is the synopsis presentation, so that most of the students can go and recall and see if you don't remember who has presented. So please go and view that also. Okay, so I am done. So Madhuri, you can conclude the session.
Okay ma'am, today we have completed the evaluation for the group numbers 13, 14, 15 and 16. So before winding up, I would like to request group number 9, 10, 11 and 12 with the evaluators group number 10, 11, 12 and 13 respectively to be ready to play their roles in the next evaluation session. So this is your host for today, Madhuri Kalani, signing off. Have a good day, everybody.
Thank you. Thank you, Madhuri. I'll stop the recording. Thank you.